Sysdig offers the first unified approach to container security, monitoring, and forensics. In practice, that's crucial. It enables enterprises to deliver more reliable and more secure software across the whole container lifecycle. Forensic analysis and postmortems are not easy on distributed, dynamic environments, especially with the ephemeral nature of containers. So when a security incident occurs, we need to rely on software to answer questions like, what happened? What was the breach? Was any data exfiltrated? How did they break into my system? Who did it? Logs can be a starting point, but we typically need to dig deeper. You might have SSH'd into your machine to perform further analysis, but that doesn't work with containers anymore. Your affected container might have been destroyed already or rescheduled into a different node. This is an exciting use case for Sysdig Secure. Sysdig provides unrivaled container forensic capabilities that allow you to inspect data outside of production, even if your containers are long gone. So let's dig into how it works. From the captures tab, we have access to all of the captures that were taken by Sysdig Secure. We can open that with Sysdig Inspect, which is an interface built specifically for container forensics, inspired by popular security tools like Wireshark. Here we can see an overview. The first thing we'll want to do is overlay the point in time in which the Sysdig Secure notification occurred. Sysdig records pre and post attack activity through system calls, allowing us to analyze everything that happened, not only after the break-in, but also before, so you can understand exactly how they did it. Each of these tiles aggregate different activities, including file system and network, application protocols traffic, security events, performance indicators, and logs. This is how we are going to be able to navigate through the 78,000 system calls recorded in this capture file. So, from a policy violation, you can drill down and inspect the contents of network connections and recreate file system activity. Within here, we can overlay things like modified files, network connections, and executed commands. Around our notification, we can correlate anomalies and narrow our search around a specific time frame. Digging further still, we can drill down into the commands executed in this time window and specifically look at this tar command. Let's switch over the files view to look at every single file that was either read or written at the exact time the suspicious file was untarred. Switching to the IO streams feature allows us to inspect in any file descriptor. So we can reconstruct the actual content of each of these files and analyze them. We find the printable view a little easier to look at. Here we can examine the source code of this malware downloaded into the container. So that's just one example of how we can analyze an incident, including looking into executed commands, finding the files that were accessed or modified, and in this case, identifying malware that was downloaded into that container, even if it's long gone. DevSecOps teams and security analysts can now run containers in production with Sysdig Secure without worrying how they might perform forensic analysis and postmortems after a security incident.